In this video, I'll show you how to merge two different Notion databases using my finance tracker and budget tracker as an example, which can be found as the first link in the description. And in the next video, I'll show you how to do this on a dashboard level by integrating my LifeOS and my Habit Tracker Hub. Now let's get started. All right, so here I have my finance tracker with a couple of income and expense database entries, and I also have a few subscriptions inside of my subscription tracker. Now, what I want to do is I want to transfer all of these database entries over to my new Notion budget tracker. So at the core, this is the same finance tracker, but you have a whole budget tracker section where you can specify a percentage for the month. You'll be able to see your total monthly budget, the amount remaining, and you can also specify a monthly goal and a monthly budget for both your income and expense sources. Now, this budget tracker also has a few extra things, like for example, this monthly database, these buttons, bank transfers between bank accounts, and a few other things, but this is not a tutorial or a walkthrough on this budget tracker. This is just a video showing you how to merge databases with each other. Now, if you want me to create a tutorial or a walkthrough for this budget tracker, then be sure to give this video a like and leave a comment down below so that I know there's demand for this budget tracker. Otherwise, I'm not going to create the video. All right, so before we start, let me first explain the process. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the information from one database, export it to a CSV file, open it inside of Excel or Google Sheets. Then we're going to modify the property name so that it matches up with the new database. Then we're going to download that CSV file again and then merge it with our new database. And then for the relations and the other properties that's not matching up, we're just going to bulk edit all of them. So if I open up a database entry on the old database, then you'll see that this one's date property is called date. And if I open up a database entry on the new database, then you'll see that this one's date property is also called date. So they're spelled exactly the same and they're both date properties. So if I export the information from the old database and import it into the new one, the date properties will stay the same because they're spelled the same and they're both the same format. But if we take a look at the bank accounts property, you'll see that this one is spelled bank account. And on the new database, it's spelled bank accounts. And because these are not named exactly the same, there will be a new property being created that is going to be called a bank account. So before you try to merge your databases with each other, make sure that the properties you're trying to match is spelled exactly the same and that they're also in the same format. However, when it comes to relation properties, like for example, the bank accounts and the income and expense sources, I would recommend that you do not match up the property names. I'll explain why later. All right, so let's now start with the process. The first thing you want to do is click on the database block menu and then open this database as a full page. Then you want to click on the page menu. You want to click on export, and then you want to make sure that you're exporting it as a CSV file. You want to make sure that it's the default view and that you're exporting everything. Then click on export and then choose a file location and save it. Then you want to go to the file and then double click it to unzip the file. And then inside of that new folder, you'll be able to find your CSV files. Now, as you can see here in the preview, this one only shows one database entry, which is this current view inside of Notion. And then the other one shows all of the database entries, which will be the one that we'll be using. Then what you want to do is you want to open up a Google Sheet or an Excel spreadsheet, go to File, click on Import, and then just upload your new CSV file. And when you get this window, just click on Import Data. And now you'll be able to see all of your database entries. And then what I always do is I just click on this first row, make it bold, increase the text size, and then I just double click on each of the columns in order to resize it according to the content. Now that our database entries are inside of our Excel spreadsheet, what we now want to do is we want to make sure that the properties are matching up to our new database, except the relation properties. We want to make sure that they're different. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up a database entry inside of the new database, and then here I'll be able to find the names of the properties. So the first relation is income sources. So I'm going to go to my new database, open up the database entry, and then here I'll be able to see if the name is the same. So as you can see, the name is exactly the same. So I'm going to go inside of Excel and then just remove an S in order to change the name. Next is the bank account relation, which is spelled bank account. And here it's spelled bank accounts. So it's already different. No need to change that. Then we have the date, expense, dollar, and profit properties, which are spelled exactly the same. Then we have the overview relation. And as you can see here, it's spelled exactly the same. So this one we're just going to retitle to overview relation. And then our last relation is expense sources, which if we go here, you'll see it's exactly the same. So we're just going to remove an S in order to change the name. So now the names of all our relation properties are different and the other properties are spelled exactly the same because we actually want to carry that information over. Now, yes, you can also just edit the property names inside of Notion, export it, and then import it back into Notion without even opening up Excel or Google Sheets. But there might be some of you who actually use Excel or Google Sheets and you want to know how to transfer the information over to Notion. But it is possible to just skip this step entirely. All right, so once you have all of your information and all the properties except the relations are named exactly the same, you want to click on File. Click on download and then download it as a CSV file. All right, so now that you have your CSV file, what you want to do is you want to go to your new database, click on the database block menu, click on merge with CSV, select your CSV file, click on open, and then just wait for Notion to import all of the database entries. So as you can see here, if we go inside of the monthly view, all of our database entries has been added. Now, if I open up one of these database entries, you'll notice that the date property, the income or expense select property, and the income and expense amount properties has been added. And now here at the bottom, you'll notice it created new properties for all the relations. So the next thing you want to do is you want to create a new table view database. On this database, you want to go inside of the database menu, go to properties, and hide all of the properties. Now what we're going to do is we're going to fix the relation properties one by one. So the first one is going to be the bank accounts. So we're going to show the bank accounts relation property as well as the new select property that has been created. Then you can exit out of the database menu. Now, as you can see here, it created select properties based on the bank account that we chose. Now, there are three ways to update property information. The first one is the slow and manual way, which is by just adding in the relation inside of each of the database entries. The second way is to click on this white checkbox to select all of the database entries. And if you have more than 50, you'll be able to click on load more at the bottom to load more database entries. And you can also change it to show up to 100. Then in order to edit the properties on this view, you can select them here, or you can edit other properties by clicking on this menu, click on edit property, and then selecting the property you want to edit. So in this case, we would click on bank accounts and then select the bank account we want to relate them to. But as you might notice, we have database entries with no bank accounts, database entries with our savings account, and ones with PayPal. So what you want to do is click on filter, click on the bank account select property, and then, for example, filter it to only show PayPal, and then you would bulk edit all of them and select the PayPal bank account. Now I'm going to undo all of this because I want to show you a better way. The third and fastest way to edit all of the properties is through a button. So what you want to do is you want to create a new button, and then this button is going to be called a bulk edit. The action for this button is going to be to edit pages in, and then we're going to select this finance tracker database. And then for this filter, we're going to select the bank account select property. We're going to select the PayPal option. And then we're going to select, we want to edit the normal bank account relation property. And we want to change it to PayPal. So now if I click on this button, it will add PayPal to this bank account relation property to all the database entries where this bank account select property is PayPal. So now if I click on done and click on bulk edit, you'll see that PayPal has been added to all of them. Now in order to do the same for savings, we're going to edit this button and we're going to change the filter to savings. And then we're also going to change this PayPal relation to the savings relation. And now if we click on done and click on bulk edit, it will add savings to all the savings database entries. Even if you have like 1,000 database entries, you won't have to scroll down every time and click on load more in order to use this bulk editing method. All you have to do is just update the button and then click it. Now, as you can see, there's two database entries that does not have a bank account selected. And because it's only two, you can click the relation and then select the bank account. But if it's like a database with 1,000 different database entries and there's like 13 of them that you want to change, you can edit this button and then you can go to the filters. You can change it to the name property and then type in the name of that database entry. So it would be ConvertKit in this case. And then for the subscription, I would remove savings and then select PayPal. Now I can click on done, click on this button, and then you'll see PayPal has been added. Now that all of our database entries has been linked to a bank account, we can delete this bank account property. Now we're going to repeat the same process, but for the income sources, the expense sources, and also the overviews database. Inside the database properties, we're going to hide the bank accounts database. We're going to show the income source property as well as the new one that has been created. Then we're going to edit this button. We're going to change the filter to the income source property that has been created. And we're going to set this to YouTube AdSense. And then the property we want to change is going to be the income source relation. And we're going to select the YouTube option. Then we're going to click on done, click on this button, and then you'll see that all of the YouTube sources has been added. And then just repeat this process for all the other income sources. Once all of the income source relations has been added, we no longer need this property, so we can just go ahead and delete it. Then you want to do the exact same, but for the expense sources. Now, as you'll notice here, when we imported the information, it didn't create a select property for the expense source, but rather a text property. If this is the case, all you want to do is just click this property, click on edit property, and then change the type to a select property. And as you can see, it automatically added everything in as options for the select property. Now again, edit the bulk edit button, go to filters, change it to where the expense source is, for example, software, and then you want to change the expense relation property and you want to select the software option. Then just click on done, click on this button, and then now all of the software relations has been added. Now once you've repeated this process for all the expense sources, we no longer need this property, so we're just going to go ahead and delete it. Now we're finished with both the income and expense sources, so I'm just going to click on it and click on hide in view. Now the last relation property that we need to do is going to be for the overview. Now as you can see for this one, this is a multi-select because there are multiple relations selected. So what we're going to do is inside of the button, we're going to change the filter to where the overview relation is 2024. And then we're going to select the overview relation property. And instead of replace with, we're going to do add. So for the 2024, we obviously want to select the 2024 database entry. Click on done, click on this button, and now all of them has been added. And then we want to do the same for the total. So we're going to edit the button. We're going to change 2024 to total, and then do the same for the overview relation. We're just going to select total, click on done, click on the button, and then now you'll see that both total and 2024 has been selected. Now that this is done, we can go ahead and delete this overview relation property. And we can also go ahead and hide this property from the view. Now, if we go to the monthly view, you'll notice that all of our properties has been added and everything's working perfectly, but we still don't have any icons for our database entries yet. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on this table view. We're going to go to filter, and then we're going to filter this database to only show the income database entries. Then we're going to click on this white square to select all of the database entries. We're going to click on this menu, go to the bottom and click on icons, and then we're going to select an icon for our income database entries. Then we're going to do the same for our expenses. So go to filters and change it from income to expenses. And then we're going to select all of them, click on this menu, go to icons, and then select an icon for our expenses. Now, if I go to the monthly view, you'll see that all of our database entries has icons and all of the property information has been added. Once everything is set up correctly, you can now delete your table view. All right, so next is the subscription tracker. For this one, I'm just going to export the information to a CSV file and then import it again into Notion without using Google Sheets or Excel, as I've already showed that process and it's not necessary. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to open up one of these database entries, go to our new database, and then open up a database entry here as well. So if we switch between these two databases, you'll notice that the names of the properties are exactly the same, which is what we want, except for the relation property, we're still going to change this. So on the old database, all we're going to do is just rename this property and remove an S. Then we can close out of this database entry. We can click on this database block menu, click on open as page, click on the page view, click on export, export it as a CSV, showing the default view, and export everything. Click on export, choose where to save the file, then double click to unzip the file, then go to your new database, click on the database block menu, click on merge with CSV, and then select your CSV file. And as you can see, all of the database entries has been added. Now what we want to do is we want to open up one of these database entries, and then as you can see here at the bottom, it created a new property for the bank account. So what we're going to do is we're going to just click on this property, click on edit, change the type to a select property, and now you'll be able to see the different options of bank accounts. Now again, you can either manually edit the properties, you can bulk edit them in a table view, or you can use the buttons to edit all of them at once. But since we only have four database entries, I'm just going to manually add in the bank account, click on this button, and then move down to the next one, and then just repeat this for all four database entries. Once all of the relation properties has been added, you can go ahead and delete the select property. And the same thing goes for the icons. You can either manually edit them or bulk edit them on a table view. But since this is for subscriptions, I always add unique icons to each of them. So I'm just going to edit them manually. And as you can see, all of our subscriptions has been successfully added. And there you go. That's how you transfer information from one Notion database into another one, or from Excel or Google Sheets into a Notion system. If you learned anything new from this video, make sure to give it a like and check out this next video, which will show how to integrate and merge different Notion dashboards with each other.